timings and it's not actually, to my mind, there is no accountability for the politicians. When we join in a company, we are giving KRAs in the first month itself that we will achieve this. After 6 months, there is an intermediate review. After 1 year, they will see that whether you have achieved it or not. Depending upon that, you will get your performance pay or the promotion, whatever it is. But there is no such review for the manifesto released by the politicians. The manifesto gets diluted in the first budget itself. In the budget, you never see whatever they have promised in the manifesto. After 4-5 years, none of them will be seen, and nobody knows what they have promised at the beginning of their term. So there is no accountability. There is no people asking them and then questioning them when they actually contest for the next election. Now we will take some questions for 3-4 minutes.
Yes, sir. Can I?
It's over.
Yes, thank you. I would round up and thank everybody for the presentations. I think it's good if you will distribute it, because they're not all present. I will have one final word. I do this kind of presentations all over the world, and I end mostly with these words, if you like them or not. If you think if the government is incompetent and corrupt, and if you think if the private sector is only there for profit and corrupt, don't start with PPP. On the other hand, if you think that the government is a very efficient and dedicated organization, and the private sector is in PPP to help to save the world and mankind, you are living in a dream world. A PPP is a business deal, which is transparent and open. If you are capable and have your professional people, you can go to a business deal. If not, you will only learn from your failures. So please treat each other as professionals, open and transparent, and then it will work, and then you will overcome all these problems, because you can address them and discuss them. But if not, you will always stay in this room doing academic research why PPP doesn't work. Thank you very much. For those who are going home, a safe trip home. For those who stay tomorrow, we're looking forward for more discussion.
I was listening against all for pro for PPP. I am for anti-PPP. I'll give you a 2 minutes example. You see, this is just a case of having a cake and eat it too. Take the example of Hyderabad Airport, how they have fooled the government and all that, how in collusion, how the agreement and how the public is suffering, how they have to pay through their nose every day. And how much he has spent, the promoter, how much, just 1,000 crores in all the PPPs. Where is the money? The money is not brought from the pocket of the entrepreneur. It is the public money. It is the financial institution's money. Financial institution, he is just, everybody, the private, the public sector is just a slave. And he is the boss for no reason. He's a boss, and he becomes a slave.
Thank you very much for your work. If you want to have more examples, I have over 300 examples where PPPs went terribly wrong, made or the government very sad or the private sector very sad. So yes, there are more examples of good PPPs and bad PPPs. There are good examples of non-projects, non-PPP, which were very good and very bad. Thank you very much. I see you.
Thank you, sir. I would like Ms. Sindhu to please present her memento to Dr. Vidya Sharma. I would like Mr. Pradeep to present a memento to Mr. C. Vijayanand.